business, in big business, in the companies, or maybe you have been working for too long and you have been forgotten. Maybe the company you're in, you have never been promoted. I've come to tell you that I have come to declare the season of your abundance. This is a season of your abundance. In the name of Jesus. In Psalms 1, in Psalm 60 verses 1 and 2, it says, arise, shine. Arise, shine. Can you give us the scripture kindly, please? Push them on the screen and then we'll make a prayer. Push them on the screen. He says, let's go together.
Oh,
thou hast. Isaiah, not Psalms. Isaiah, I'm wondering, where are we reading? Isaiah, 60%. Yeah. Isaiah 60, verses 1. Verses 1. Uh-huh. Let's go. Arise, shine. For the light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. Verse 2. For behold, darkness shall come on the earth, and gross darkness. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory. Now he says, mark this, he did not say, arise and. You know there's a difference. So he said, arise, shine. That means it's your season from where you are and what circumstance you are in. Whether it doesn't matter your status of life. It says, arise and then you shine. Why? The glory of God has come on you. So if you are a believer, you must understand that the season for your blessing has come.
Amen.
And this is why God sends a prophet to tell you that you are saying, heal thee, all thy wounds. Says the Lord. Because you have been called, because they call you what? An outcast, says the Zion, whom no man. It does not matter how much sickness that come. The Bible says, stay put and declare the word of God, because he said, let the sick say, I am healed. Let the weak say,
I am strong.
Even if there is evidence, you know, some people say, Pastor, even if you tell me that I'm healed, and yet I'm still feeling, I'm still sick. Let me tell you, they are facts. They are facts.
Yes.
You may have a fact. A fact, meaning that you have a doctor's report that says your condition is bad and you're in bed. And now here we are telling you, declare, I am healed. And you say, Pastor, even if I declare, I'm still sick. But let me tell you, there is only one thing that can nullify a fact. When in Isaiah 37, God said to Ezekiel, go to the dry bones. And he took him to the dry bone and told him, walk across and back and forth and tell me whether the bones will live. He said, Lord, it's only you who know if the bones will live or not. But I tell you, the bones are very, very, very dry. And God said, Ezekiel, that is a fact on the ground, but there is the application of truth that can nullify the facts. Even if the bones are very dry, activated by application of truth. So the only thing can change the fact is truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So when you call on the name of the Lord and begin to prophesy to your situation, the facts shall begin to melt out. And I challenge you now, declare the truth to your situation. Even if they are dry as bones of Ezekiel, in the valley of dry bones, you can tell them, I prophesy to you. You may be dry, but I call life in the name of Jesus. Are you ready to call life now?
Yes.
He says, I will restore your health. It does not matter how much, what is your condition. The Bible says, him that trusted upon the Lord, the Lord shall restore your health. Declare, oh God,
I
let's declare,
I am healed.
My situation is changing. My life is changing.
My life is changing.
In the name of Jesus, can you activate that prayer? Activate that prayer. In a few seconds, activate. Whatever now shall declare, the Lord shall establish. In the name, I declare to you this year, before the end of the season, the Lord Lord shall make a visitation. May the Lord visit your life. May the Lord visit your business. May the Lord visit your marriage. May the Lord visit your house. In the name of Jesus. Declare, oh God, every power that I've got to die in this season for me to arise, die now. Die now. Declare that in your life now. In a few seconds, declare every power that I've got to die. Every power that I've got to die for my life to arise. Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you as we hear the word. Open up our spirit, my Lord. No principality or settings. Oh God, even of a mind. That Lord, our mind shall not be swayed from here to there. But I declare by the entrance of your word. Lord, there is liberty. Liberate your people by the hearing of your word. Heal your people by the hearing of your word. Restore your people by the hearing of the word. I thank you and I welcome your presence, Holy Spirit. Be the generous superintendent of this service. Now, Lord, we give you all the honor and glory. Lord, we thank you for Father Bishop Jimmy and Mama. And I declare, Lord, that you shall bless them because of this work they have done. Bless their faith, dear Father. Encourage them even when the discouragements are setting in. I pray that your empowerment shall be upon this church. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Give the Lord a shout of praise again. You may be seated in the presence of God. Hallelujah. It is a honor to be here again. This is where I've been trained here. Yeah, I've been trained. When I say we, it's from our church, and my leaders and myself, my wife, have been trained here, and I'm not a visitor here. I've been here for quite a while. Father Swissana. It's an honor to be here. Thank you, ma'am, for this opportunity. And I bless the Lord. Greetings for my wife, Grace. She sent me greetings this morning. For those of you who know her, she's preaching a bishop. J.B. Masinda, father, was coming to our church, but he canceled it. And then when somebody wants to preach for us, then and now when we say the bishop had canceled the appointment, he said I'm also in it. So Grace had to remain. She was to be with me here. But anyway, we thank God. It's always the next time. But I swear. Now this morning, I have a word from the Lord. A few weeks ago, we've been praying in our church. Asking God the direction of the church. And the Lord spoke to me and said, remind my people. I heard very clearly, and the Lord said, remind my people because they have forgotten. And when anybody forgets, it becomes a grievous sin. So if you count any sin that is written in the Bible, forgetting is one. God says, it's an offense to forget. And when you forget, you walk out in defeat. And God would want us to walk in victory. But anytime you forget, it's just like forgetting an examination. When you forget some of the answers, you find that you leave the blank spaces and you don't pass the exam. Or when you forget where you are going, then you go into a divert route. So again, you are diverted. But when you remember, then you know you are on the right course. Amen. So this morning, I want to share with you on the unrighteousness to those that forget. Unrighteousness to those that forget. Now, it is from the book of Hebrews 6:10. Let's go to Hebrews 6:10. The Bible says that God is not unjust or unrighteous. God is not, I like that. God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which he has shown towards his name, and in that he has ministered to the saints and do minister. That means as you continue to minister, God says it is unrighteous. It is a sin to forget. And he says God cannot forget the work of his hand. That means anytime you are in the service of God, God remembers. Anytime you are working for God, God remembers. And remember, it is out of your service to God. Because some people ask, how do I serve God? Some think that by becoming a pastor, you serve God. No. No. You can serve God at any capacity. Whether you are a teacher, Yes, wherever you are, whatever you are doing, you can serve God. And the way to serve God is to serve his people. Look at what he says. He said, God cannot forget your work and the labor of your life, which he have shown, which you have shown through his name, and you have ministered to the saints. So God remembers the ministry to the saints. And God values the ministry to the saints. Now we can never say you love God if you do not love your neighbor. If you do not love your friend. If you do not love your fellow worker. I mean, you only serve God, or in many other ways, but through love to the people. Amen.
Amen.
So he says, God cannot forget, but we forget. We forget. We are human beings, we forget. And he says, those who forget are unrighteous. Most people are conscious about the four big sins, like stealing, lying, fornication, murder, and so on. But if they don't remember that forgetting is a sin equal to the rest. So in Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 32, Jeremiah 2, 32, he says, that's a young woman. Now, if God compares us with a maiden, he says, can a maid forget her an ornament or a bridal attire? Yet my people have forgotten me days without number. God is lamenting. The church has forgotten me. The church has forgotten my statues and my word. The church has not done what they are supposed to do. God has an expectation for every one of us. Because God is with. Brethren, remember, as much as we ask God for everything in this life, to have houses, to have cars, to have our children, to have fame, to be what we want to become, there is a kingdom of God where we are going. Remember, what we do now determines how we shall live in the next world. That you should remember. Because Jesus said, you are not of the world, you are a passing. And if we are passing, then we must remind ourselves that what we do here affects what we shall become on the other end. Because that's where we are going. So if you know that you are going there, prepare it now. Because this is a platform for preparation. You cannot prepare yourself when you die. You cannot prepare yourself when you are weak. We prepare now. This is a time to prepare ourselves for where we are going. Therefore, you minimize the errors now, so that when the Lord shall come, we shall be with him in the glory. So it is very key. And there are things that we must remember. He says, if a maiden cannot forget her bride, her ornaments, if she cannot forget, then we should not also not forget. Amen.
Amen.
In scripture, this is likened to an unfathomable possibility that a bride can forget her wedding gown during the wedding. It's a comparison. God says, if that can happen to that one, then what about the church? People grow and forget who cared for them. Now hear me. People grow and they forget who nurtured them, who favored them, who bred them. To a place we can forget our parents. Because some of us have parents, but when you ask, when did you ever go home? Some have 3 years, 2 years, 5 years, and the reason is, maybe I have no money to go to, to take home or something like that. But remember, you can never forget where God has brought you from. Because God says, remember where you came from so that you can locate your bearing to where you are going. You can never know where you are going if you forget where you came from. Are you with me? So he says, it is the origin. Remember your origin. And actually we begin from where we came from. That means where your father was, where your mother is, that's where you came from. And that is where your blessings begin. Your blessing does not begin by the discovery of Christ. No, it begins from your home. If you have not a carrier of blessing from your home, then you are a wanderer in this life. In Ephesians 6, verses 2, he says, it is a command, if you can talk quickly, it's a command that God has given us. He says, honor your father and mother. It is not bowing to them. It is not even sweet talking them on telephone. It is real. It is real visiting. It is presenting yourself to receive honor. Now, if you are not honored in where you come from, then you can never be honored by anybody. Believe you me. If you are not honored at your home, you cannot be honored by people on the street where you meet other friends. They will betray you. Honor begins from where you came from. He says it's a command that means when you go home, bless them. Learn to bless your parents. If you came and your mother was going to the river to fetch water and you grew her fetching water, even now she's still fetching water and you are working, it's a crime. That's a crime. And it shows how ignorant you are because you have forgotten. If whatever, if when you got the job, the first thing is deliver them from the situation. Deliver them from what they are. As you look at me, oh, to the cosana na mama yangu, to me cosana. When I was a near nini, I'm going to go. I'm going to go. When I was a near wapi. I mean, you can never stand and you know, atuseme kazee kamechoka, kananiambia unajua zile ulikuwa ielewi.com, wewe Mungu haelewangi hizo vitu. Mungu ajui mambo ya.com, anajua homa. Ama anasema sana.
Amen.
So if you honor them, then again you cannot force them to honor. In signs of honor, you can honor them by making them food, you can honor them by blessing them. And what happened? He says, if you honor your father, it's a command. But the command is a promise. What happened? Verses 4. And after that, it may go well with you. Thank you. It may go well with you, and that you may what? Enjoy life. Some of us have no capacity to enjoy because we have never honored our parents. You can never enjoy when honor is not given. Who gave you power to enjoy? Let me tell you, do you know happiness will never come because you are driving a car or you are owning a house or even you are in business or you are employed? No, it comes by empowerment. When you are empowered, then happiness comes. Well, so he says, by honoring our parents, then we have longevity of life and we have the capacity to enjoy. There is an enjoyment that goes beyond words that can express. Why? There is power in your life. I'm telling you, kija Nairobi hakuna deal like mono yote itakushika. Unakuja Nairobi na kukubali peke yake kwa sababu tayari baraka zimetoka wapi? Yeah, anasema long life. So long life does not come by careful eating. That you are eating this, you are only eating that is not long life. That is another opposite. That's another religion. So long life comes by the blessings of your parents. It is not by how much you eat or what you don't eat. No. It is a blessing that comes out there. When now you come here, your pastor blesses you, your life becomes a wonder. I and the children that the Lord has given you are so signs. So you become a sign. And your children become a sign. So the family become a sign of wonders. Amen. Remember to remember. Now ask somebody. If somebody asks you, who has ever blessed you? Well, maybe my pastor blessed you. Okay, fine. But who else have ever blessed you? Now, your brother cannot bless you. Your sister cannot bless you. Your uncle cannot bless you unless it's been given authority by your father. It's only your father that can bless.
Yes.
Now, who has blessed you? So, now we're going to make a kafu. Because I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to make a kubariki. You know, do you know what? This is going to ask you out. Oh, I was rejected. Get a mind. What's on a bukata? People look at you, they don't like you. Because the Bible, you are blessed. If you go back there and tell them to bless you, what happened? Wherever you appear, the blessing locates you. Wherever you stand, the blessing locates you. Because what? The favor of God and the command of His word. And I said, enjoy long life on earth. So enjoyment, actually that translation says success. For you to be successful, it's not only how much educated you are, but how much blessed you are. Hallelujah. Yeah. Now, people that forget, he says, in scripture, it is like that. Okay, I am sorry for that. He said, people who grow and forget who cared for them, who nurtured their life to the point of forgetting their parents. Now, number two, he says, they forget those who brought them to Christ. Whoever brought you to Christ, you didn't say how. Those who raised you up in the Lord and put you in ministry, you forgot. And I told the first seven that God does not come from heaven. He uses people.
Oh, yeah.
God uses people. Tell me, nani ameku, Mungu akikubariki, wakati unapombea baraka, atukombea baraka malaika tokeka kule sema, mimi ni Gabrieli, sasa nimekuja kubariki. Haezi tokea Gabrieli. Haezi. Anatumia Kamau, Joki, Onyango. Mungu anatumia watu kukubariki. Nani anasema, analete destiny connectors to you. Analete watu wakukunganisha. Kuna destiny connectors that God will send. And these men and women, no matter their standard, wanakuasha to the higher office. And you must remember that because some of them will stoop down for you to climb on their back. Wanalala chini. O unakanyaga midongo yao na unaenda mbali. Unakanyingina na inyama chini. Unakanyanga, unapanda juu. Na ukienda pale juu, unasahau wale umekanyanga. God says, remember. Remember them. Remember them that have blessed you, that have laid hand on you, that have laid. How can you forget? You can never forget. How can you forget someone who helped you in the crossroads of your life? You cannot forget. Remember those people that helped you. Bless them at times. Visit them and say thank you so that you can go to your next level. Amen. Now, number four, people forget when they prosper. Immediately somebody prospers, he forgets where he came from. He forgets even the people that blessed him. You change your lifestyle.
When you get education, you become a great man. It is true, you can. But don't forget, this greatness from Psalm 75, he says it's the Lord who promotes people. He raises others and brings others down. But again, from the book of Ecclesiastes 9:11, Ecclesiastes, he says, if you can read from your Bible, I think it's good. It's good to look at it. Ecclesiastes 9:11. Ecclesiastes 9:11. He says, I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift, or the battle to the strong, or food to those who are wise, or wealth to the brilliant, or favor to the learned. But time and chance happen to all. That means every one of you, learned and unlearned, great or ungreat, there is a chance of life. God will bring an opportunity, a chance of grace that you must sail up. Because your time has come.
Amen.
And that is why we must learn the principle of sowing, of blessing others. If you see somebody getting married, and you have daughters and sons, make sure you drop an offering and tell them, my brother, I planted this seed for you, even on behalf of my children, that the Lord bless you as you get married. Why? You know that you are putting a seed for your children. The Lord shall remember the seed. Mtu amenunua mpya. Unaona pasa nena kombea karembia. Unapata mbegu unasema Bwana, hii 2000, I'm giving a sacrifice. Put fuel on it. I'm telling you, God will turn the wheel around. You'll drive a new car, a newer than him, and a better than what they were praying for. Why? God does not forget the seed that you have given. You plan. When you plan, God remembers. But if you don't plan, what happens? You become a complainer. Unasema, oh, can you say I pay the water? Aye, tembelei watu wao ni tembelea nani? Wakati uko unapanda mbegu, wao unapanda unapanda gani? Kwa sababu kuna vitu tuelewe, kwa watu wanatuelewa, tuelewane. Mtu mmoja aliniuliza, "Pastor, nitajuaje mimi nitaenda mbinguni?" Aliniuliza, akaniambia, "Niambie, how will I know that I'll go to heaven?" I told him, "It's very simple. In the Revelation 21 verses 8, it tells you whether you're going to look at verses 1 to 8. Revelation 21 verses 8. Hiyo yote itakwambia whether you are going to heaven or not. Hata mtaki Ndio ukisoma hiyo na uone hauko hapo. Mambo yako haiko hapo. Basi. Nikamwambia pia ni mzuri kujua kama utapata taji ama hapana. Unasikua kanisani kwa miaka mingi na una taji. Ukitaka kujua hiyo ni Matthew 25:1. Ukisoma mpaka chini itakwambia kuna watu walienda hospitali wakaona watu. Kuna watu walikuwa na njaa wakapewa chakula. Kuna watu walikuwa prison wakafikiwa. Wewe umefika kama hauko katika hiyo, then ujue kwamba taji upate. Amen.
Amen.
That is very key. So that you don't keep asking, hata kuomba, God, remember, angalia hiyo scripture. Itakuambia kama unaenda mbinguni ama huendi. Itakuambia kama wewe utapata taji mbinguni ama upati. Itakuambia maana unasikia leo watu wanatangaziwa tunaenda kuona kwa wagonjwa, tunaenda kuona. You can read the scripture on your own. You exactly know that if I'm not qualified here, then definitely no crown. Amen. So again, Ecclesiastes, it is not the swift for battle or the strong that gets food. It is not the wise. It is not the wealth and the brilliant or the favor or the learned, but it's a time and chance. So every one of us have a chance in life to become a great man. You have a chance to become a great woman. And if you get that chance, seize the opportunity. Amen. Well, that's where I'm at. Deuteronomy 8:17. Maybe you can quickly rush through the scriptures. Deuteronomy. He says, you may say to yourself, my power and the strength of my help or my hand have produced this wealth for me. Let me tell you, your prosperity has nothing to do with your power or your strength. It has all to do with God. Uh-huh. Say, go to 18. He says, but remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you what? Ability or the power to produce wealth. And so confirm this covenant that is okay. So it's all about covenant. If you connect to the covenant, then you become successful. Your struggles will not be there. Again, remember, it is God who directs your feet to succeed. That is from Isaiah 48:17. It is God, give us Isaiah 48:17. Isaiah 48:17. It is God that directs you. It is not you. That you just stumble and think, this is what the Lord says, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord, your God, who teaches you what is best for you and who directs you the way you should go. It is God who directs your feet. So when you wake up in the morning and go, it is God. That's why we are told, make sure you pray and take authority over that day. God has given us a blank check from the book of Psalms 139:15-17, and asema, the days, the members of your life are written on a book. That means every day is a page. Monday is a page. Tuesday is a page. Wednesday is a page. It is you to write what you want. According to Job 38:12. And asema, write whatever you want. That means when you pray, you cut the earth on it. Okay, give us a scripture properly. It says, have you ever given orders to the morning or shown the dawn is placed? That means, this is not for pastors, it's every one of us. Give orders to the morning and show dawn is placed. That means you must command the day and get the results. Verses 13. Go to 13. That it might take the earth by the edges and shake the wicked out. That means anytime you wake up in the morning and pray and declare the goodness of God in the day listens. And the day takes the prayer. If you lie, if you leave your house in the morning, you will not need to pray over that day. Why? You have taken the blessings of the day. So the earth will behave according to your prayer. So if there are wicked men in your company or in your place and they have schemed evil against your life, what happened? They will be shaken out by your prayer and your declaration in the morning. So when you come, everything submit to you. Why? Go to 14. Go to 14. The earth takes shape like a clay and a sea. Its features stand out like those of a garment. That means the earth will take shape according to your prayer.
Oh, yeah.
That is why you must pray between midnight and 4 o'clock in the morning. If you wake up at 5, the day is gone. You see what menda. Mata sasa unasikia kwa nini wengine ndugu zetu wameenda na wanaomba mara moja kenye mzima inanyamaza. Sio naelewa mimi nasema.
sasa wewe unashika unashikaga maana demonic authorities and principalities operate between 2 and 3. That is when they take commands, and when they take orders, they act, they go to different places, and that is when you take the authority and declare, God, I command this day to be. I command it. Let me tell you, ukiingia matatu inanyamaza. Hakuna hata kama ilikuwa inafanyishwa accident, shetani akiona umekalia anaondoka upite. Nothing happens. That is why a Christian must pray between midnight and 4. Ukiamka 5. Psalms 137 verses 1. Look at Psalms 137. The unrighteous people are not conscious of the danger of forgetting. Unrighteous people, because God said, I'm not unrighteous. If God says I'm not unrighteous, then it means if you forget, you become unrighteous. He says, unrighteous people forget. They are not conscious of the danger of forgetting. Psalms 137 verses 1. Psalms 137. Psalms 137. Inasema, by the rivers of Babylon, we sat and wept. We remembered Zion. You know the song? By the rivers of, he says, we sat and wept as two, keep moving as two. He says, verses 2. There on the palace, we hung our hearts. That 3. For there our captors asked us for a song. Our tormentors demanded songs of joy. They said, sing us one of the songs of Zion. Verse 4. How can we sing the song of the Lord while in foreign land? Verse 5. If I forget you, O Jerusalem, may my right hand forget. May my right hand be cut off. If I forget you, O Jerusalem. Verse 6. May my tongue cling onto the roof of my mouth. If I do not remember you, if I do not consider Jerusalem my highest joy. So remember, it is a sin to forget. You cannot forget the Lord. You remember the Lord. And I'll tell you, if in everything you remember God, your life will be easy. You will walk at ease. That's why many people because again, it is what drives you and maintains you. It is what drives you that sustains you. If you are driven by God, He will sustain you. If you are driven by prayer, it will sustain you. But if you are self-driven, then you sustain yourself. Now, they forget God when they are full. Rich people forget God when they drive a car or they own a house. Let me tell you, never forget God because you are driving or because you have a house. Remember God. It is Him that has given you that life. That is why anytime you wake up in the morning, the first thing is to thank God. The first thing you wake up, naturally, they say, and some of the medical doctors even agree with me, it is prudent that you wake up at 6 and go out and get fresh air. Hapo unafungua madirisha yako, unakaa huko kwa ghorofa juu, unafungua madirisha hapa ya asubuhi inakuja, inakuwa na uponyaji. I don't know, even that's my traditional belief. Amen. Actually, that's what I was taught. At 6 sharp, I'm out and I'm just speaking to the Lord and thanking God for that day. Why? Remember, when you wake up, the English men tell us, when you wake up, you are from a fast. And you break your fast by taking tea. We call it breaking fast. I understand. Yeah, you're breaking the fast. So before you break the fast, you thank God for have kept you by the night. And let me tell you, it is prudent to remember God always in your life. Remember, everything about you is about God. Yes. And that's why I see the singer say, morning by morning, you must see, I see. All I have needed, thy hands are provided. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is faithful. When you rise in the morning, He's with you. When you walk out of your house, He's with you. When you get the challenges of life, He's with you. You've got to thank Him and say, Lord, I thank you for your faithful. Morning by morning, you're faithful. Let me tell you, you'll live longer. You will not see difficulties. Why? It's the driving power of your life. But if you just wake up, you rush to work, let me tell you, anything else can wait. Your cousin has a car. You just worship him. And worship him. Let me tell you, no one can touch your life. Why? It's the driving force. Remember, in Deuteronomy, when you are eating, the best time to pray, it is not before you eat. Because many of us pray, it's good to pray for food before you eat because you sanctify it by prayer. According to 1 Timothy chapter 4, you sanctify it by prayer. But he says, when you are eaten and are satisfied, it's the best time to thank God. Sio tu umeshiba umeenda kulala, ndio unatoka unaenda kwa kuona shukuru Mungu nimekula, nimekunywa, nimeona ile. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 10. Give us Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 10. It's very important. Some of the things that you need to remember so that next day, he says, and when you are eaten, you have eaten and are satisfied, praise the Lord your God for the good land he has given you, for the good job he has given you, for the good business he has given you. Verse 11. God, verse 11. He says, be careful not, be careful that you do not forget the Lord your God, failing to observe his commands, his laws, and his decrees that I'm giving you today. So we have it again written for us. Verse 12, go to verse 12. Otherwise, when you eat and are satisfied, when you build fine houses and settle down, verse 13, and when your herds and flocks grow large, and your silver and gold increases, you all have been multiplied. But after verse 14, it says, then your heart will become proud and you will forget the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt and out of slavery, who brought you out of Baranda and out of Masada. You remember where? Says the Lord Almighty. Is it not you, priests, who show contempt for my name? But you ask, how have we shown contempt for your name? It's because we fail to honor God. We think that anything that we do in the church is acceptable. It is not. He says, if you continue reading, he says, if the offering you give, you are told to give it to your governor, will your governor accept the offering? And if he does, then it is honorable to the Lord. But if he will not accept, he will rebuke you by that offering. Then change your ways and change your approach on the Lord. Stand on your feet. Lift your hand and tell God, God, restore me back. Restore me back. Lift your hand and declare, Lord, restore me back. Father, I pray this morning that out of the word we have heard, may we not forget. May we remember to remember. May we remember the Lord. May we remember, Lord, where we have come from. And remember those who have assisted us, those who have helped us. And we hold them esteem as men of God, as women of God, as servants of God, as ladders that, Lord, we have used to climb to be where we are today. I bless you, my Father. Thank you for the life of your people. Those who are struggling in this life shall not struggle. By the entrance of your word, I pray for liberation. Liberate your people, Lord. Liberate them this coming week. Give them favor and grace. May they see victory over their life. May they see God upon their situation. In the name of Jesus, heal their bodies. Heal their lives. And Lord, restore them back. I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Give a Lord a shout.